To the men and women of the Boston Police Department, we salute! So you want to be a cop? You think you're ready for the streets? Bodies are dropping every day out here, and you think this is a game? If you think you're ready for the force, then you better be ready to train like you are. Our elite fitness headquarters consists of 3 segments, including criminal chasing, academy training, and coffee breaks. But before we get started, make sure to subscribe and check out my book in the description below, or I'll arrest you myself. Starting with the dead treadmill, followed by incline treadmill sprints, then jump squats, and jumping lunges. Put your hands behind your head. Put your hands behind your head. That's what I used to tell those asshole drug dealers when they tried to run away from me. Good thing I built up my endurance with the dead treadmill to start my endurance workouts. Place your hands on the handlebar and start pushing with your legs to get momentum. Build up speed with the quads, going as fast as you can so you can get that son of a bitch. Get to a sprinting speed and maintain as long as you can while keeping your back at a tilted angle while keeping it straight. Once you've caught that scumbag after a minute, slow down. Sometimes that son of a gun will run uphill, so we used to continue our endurance training with incline sprints. Increase the treadmill incline to 15 and the speed to 9.0. Hop on and run like your promotion depends on it. Keep the arms by your side and fingers extended to get the best running form possible. As one leg is behind you, the opposite arm is in front of you for optimal speed. Keep your feet straight, look forward, and breathe constantly. Before that prick criminal would even think about running, I would jump that jerk so fast, he didn't even know what was coming. Working on leg power and strength here, as we squat down and bring your arms down with you. Go a little lower than 90 degrees, inhaling down, and then explode up, swinging the arms up and jumping up vertically. Flex your feet up so you're jumping with the toes and keep the legs straight while in the air. Land with the toes first, then the heel, and descend back down all in one motion. Superset jump squat with jumping lunges, which will give you the ultimate advantage when chasing down these wannabe gangsters. Start in a stationary lunge, then bend both knees down to 90 degrees and explode up just like the jump squats. While in the air, bring the opposite leg forward and back so we hit both sides evenly. Make sure to transition with finesse so as soon as you land, you're bending down to that 90 degree angle again on both legs. The front foot is flat and the back has the pressure on the toes. Hold the fist this time with no arm movement. Before my partner Chuck and I were making daily arrests, you best believe we graduated from the academy at the top of our league. We did everything from push-ups, plank-ups, plank taps, and pull-ups. All that training came in real handy when we tackled those lowlifes to the ground. Ain't that right, Chuck? After you salute your lieutenant, fall face forward and land in a push-up position, going right down into those push-ups, going at a fast tempo to work on chest and endurance. Arms in line with shoulders, back straight, neck straight, shoulders retracted, 45 degree arm angle, abs tight, glutes tight, and go all the way down to the floor. Do 20 to 30 reps, and Lieutenant Bob will be proud. Sergeant Dan knew the importance of shoulder and arm strength when we had to put an a-hole criminal in a chokehold. Start in a plank position with the body straight and come up to a push-up position by placing one hand on the floor and using the strength from that one arm to come up and follow with the other arm. Come up down to a plank position by putting that first arm you came up with back down on the forearm and switch sides. Supersetting plank ups with plank taps. Start in a push-up position and with one arm and hand, tap the opposite shoulder. Place that same arm and hand down and switch sides. Keep that body straight, your core and muscles tight, and feet wide for balance. If you even look like a suspect, I'll pull you down to the precinct for booking so fast, you won't even know what hit you. Grab the bar with a wide grip and palms facing away from you. Keep
Keep the shoulders retracted, come up straight, then bring your chin above the bar and your elbows tucked by your side. Breathe out going up, inhale going down.
After almost 20 years on the force, I ain't the young buck I used to be. So I spent a lot more time in the coffee shop waiting for my retirement pension. I start to notice a little flab in the arms and abs. So I gotta get back in the gym. Ain't that right, Chuck? We starting off with coffee concentration curls, followed by dumbbell kickback, then finishing with toe crunches, supersetted with V crunches.
Being that I ain't the young buck I used to be, I spend way more time in the coffee shop. At least I get to work on those biceps for arm strength when drinking my morning coffee with cream and two Splendors. Sit down on a bench and put your elbows against the knee to work the upper bicep muscles. Start off with your arms straight and the coffee cup in your hand. Squeeze the bicep and get the full range of motion to get a sip while it's still nice and hot. Then switch sides. For optimal coffee drinking, we gotta work on the triceps as much as I prefer to sit on my ass and do highway patrol. Grab two dumbbells and tilt the back forward while keeping it straight. Keep the elbows glued to the side and start with the weights up by your shoulders with the palms facing each other. Exhale as you fully extend the arms behind you. Even my wife and kids telling me how much of a fat fuck I turned into. Lie on your back with your feet up and extend your arms up. Keep the abs tight and lift the upper back off the floor. Keep the lower back firm against the ground and bring the hand as close as you can to your feet. Supersetting this with V-ups, bringing the legs down and the arms back, working on lower and upper abs this time. Arms and legs are as straight as they can be and the abs are still staying tight. Neck is looking up at the ceiling, and you're exhaling while your arms and legs come up, inhaling when going down.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, or you're going downtown. Stay tuned till next week.